The 10th Parliament has been on the spot over the 64 billion shillings to be given out to lawmakers to buy cars. Each MP will get 150 million shillings. But it appears the backlash for the MPs arises because of the huge size of Parliament, which has 427 members. President Yoweri Museveni, while addressing the new MPs after the election of Speaker and Deputy Speaker early this year, said there is no problem with having many MPs.
This big Parliament is a Parliament of liberation, liberating the whole country, but also liberating the subgroups in the country, and I have no apologies for that.
Now the opposition FDC party has called MPs affiliated to the party for a meeting to discuss the expenditure and forge a way forward on how FDC will tackle the combustible issue of cars and other parks that have caused the storm.
The party tomorrow will be discussing the issues of expenditure in Parliament and will be issuing guidelines to our MPs. What we expect them, they may go against it, but at least as the party will tell them, we think you don't go beyond this, the line. That line will be drawn by the party.
Opposition MPs have come under fire for their loud silence on such expenditure. The critics say they choose to see or hear no evil when these monies benefit to them individually.
All of us MPs, because of guilt, will keep quiet. That I can tell you, including those who are FDC. As long as you don't speak against the excesses or you are a beneficiary of those excesses, you certainly have to keep quiet.
FDC spokesman Ibrahim Ssemujju Nganda, who is also the opposition chief whip, urges Parliament to cut down expenditure on cars and burial expenses for MPs, with each budgeted to be sent off at 68 million shillings in case they die. But some fellow opposition MPs don't agree with Ssemujju.
We spend near more than 100 billion shillings on vehicle maintenance. We spend near 100 billion shillings on buying fuel and lubricants. What we need to do is revise the policy. At least personally, I'll be in support of reducing the number of government people that will give vehicles. For example, at Parliament, we can give the Speaker and Deputy Speaker and Leader of Opposition, and we'll be the clerk. Even senior staff of Parliament can be helped to go and borrow and buy vehicles, including us members of Parliament. And that should be extended to each and every government department.
Uganda as a whole has a lot of wasteful expenditures. And if we want to trim down on the expenditures of government, then we should trim everywhere. The judiciary, you know, the judges, they have holidays, they have lead cars, they have security, gardeners.
Just in case it happened and a member of parliament dies, say from the extreme place, like Karamoja, Verefa, Okisoro, and the body has to be transported first from the village to Parliament for the honor as designated in the law and the procedures, the burial procedures of Parliament. And then later on, the body is taken back to the constituency for burial. Definitely, Parliament would spend a lot of money.
FDC has also asked the administration of Parliament not to intimidate journalists who report advanced stories and also to stop harassing demonstrators.
While I accept that the media is not beyond criticism, I think Parliament should also learn to listen. If the public that we represent say what you are doing is wrong, you then don't go and visit that anger on the media. You listen to what the public is saying. The same applies to activists who came to Parliament to protest.
In the 9th Parliament, each MP was given 103 million shillings for vehicles, but the figure has been since raised to 150 million shillings to factor in the shilling-dollar exchange rate fluctuation. The Parliamentary Commission will spend over 64 billion shillings compared to the 38.6 billion in the 9th Parliament. Suhail Mugabe, NTV.